the West Antarctic ice sheet collapsed, it would raise sea levels by an average 3.3 metres worldwide. But is it going to collapse? The answer is, like with many climate what-if questions, that it depends on what we do now and in the coming decades. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button and share it far and wide. And if you really like the video, please consider supporting me on Patreon, which you can do via the link in the description. The West Antarctic is warming much faster than the rest of the continent. Surface air temperatures have risen by 2 or 3 degrees in the last half a century, driving the melting of ice on land from above. But crucially, that temperature rise is not restricted to the atmosphere. Ocean temperatures have warmed by as much as 1 degree since the middle of the last century, and while that might not sound like much, it's made a world of difference to the floating ice in West Antarctica. The West Antarctic ice sheet has a pretty unique geography. Unlike the East Antarctic, much of the rocky bed beneath the West Antarctic is below sea level, so the ice forms a kind of dome over what would otherwise be a bay. The ice sheet on land flows towards the ocean, with glaciers spewing ice into the sea. And where they meet the sea, glaciers spread out and form ice shelves, which are these floating platforms of ice sandwiched between a warming ocean and a warming atmosphere. Rising ocean temperatures mean that more and more warm water is able to make its way underneath those floating ice shelves, causing them to melt from below. The point where the ice is attached to the rock underneath separates the floating ice shelf from what we call the grounded ice sheet, and that pinning point is known as the grounding line. Because the bedrock underneath the West Antarctic slopes backwards, ocean-driven melting creates a reinforcing feedback where melt causes further melt in an increasing cycle. When that warmer ocean water can sneak under the ice shelves, it pushes the grounding line backwards, creating a larger cavity under the ice shelf because the seabed beneath it slopes down. Then, more and more warm ocean water can penetrate under the shelf, driving more melting, so you can see how this carries on. Losing ice shelves by themselves doesn't contribute to sea level rise because they're already floating. But the consequences don't stop there. When you lose ice from the ice shelves, there's less to hold back the glaciers flowing from the land, meaning the ice sheet starts to lose much more ice, which of course does end up in the oceans. Currently, two of West Antarctica's glaciers, the Pine Island and Thwaites glaciers, single-handedly contribute 5% of total global sea level rise. The ice shelf that restrains the Pine Island glacier is thinning too, and in February 2020, it lost a huge chunk when an iceberg the size of Malta broke away. This whole process of ice shelf loss is sometimes known as marine ice sheet instability. So called because ice shelf melt and retreat is an unstable and self-sustaining process that acts around the edges of the ice sheet bordering the ocean. But I hate to break it to you, there's another kind of instability that we should be worried about. Once ice shelves start collapsing and retreating, they expose vast ice cliffs, sometimes hundreds of meters tall. The higher the cliff, the more quickly icebergs will break away from the cliff face, which will create higher cliffs, which will produce more icebergs, and so on and so on. This second form of instability is called marine ice cliff instability, and I'm sure you can see why. We've been less able to study marine ice cliff instability because it's thought that it will likely kick in after ice shelves are lost. So it's predicted to have a bigger effect in several decades' time with greater levels of climate heating. It's already been observed in Greenland, which is melting much faster than Antarctica. Some scientists suggest that marine ice cliff instability could dramatically increase the amount of sea level rise from Antarctica, even doubling the projected increases this century. Recent work shows that Antarctica could be sensitive to dramatic ice loss via this process if we warm the planet by more than 2 degrees above pre-industrial levels. The West Antarctic ice sheet is considered more vulnerable than other parts, and the threshold for its collapse is probably somewhere between 1.5 and 2 degrees Celsius. The loss of the West Antarctic ice sheet is a climate tipping point, beyond which change becomes irreversible on human timescales. It's just one of the transformational changes we will see in the cryosphere if we continue to spew greenhouse gas emissions into the atmosphere and if we continue to do very little to limit our impacts on the planet. What we do now and in the coming decades is so important. At the upcoming climate summit in Glasgow in November 2021, we must agree on legally binding pathways to limit warming to 2 degrees at the very most. Because if we don't, the planet we leave for future generations will be a very different place.